For more bodies has been scaled down, but the search teams remain optimistic that they could find more after they recovered the body of a child earlier this morning. Young children were the most affected victims of the Salai Dam tragedy that happened on Wednesday last week. Of the 49 individuals who lost their lives in the horror incident, 23 were children. Our Nakuru-based reporter Elphas Lagat has been with the search and rescue teams.
Stanley Njoroge, the head teacher for Solai Nakinyo Primary School, is a bereaved man. 13 of the 23 children who died when one of the Patel dams broke its banks on the tragic Wednesday night are from his school.
This dam has swept 14 of our pupils, that is 9 from the ECD. We have 5 girls and 4 boys. In the primary section, we have 5 children, that is 3 girls and 2 boys, a total of 14. So we feel that we have been brought down.
Residents are not satisfied that the search mission, which was massively scaled down yesterday, has fully served its purpose. This comes in the wake of a new discovery of the body of a boy, which was found in between a fault at Nyandarua village.
Lakini kenye iko, mimi naonelea, watu wako kwa machimo, hawajaicha. Kenye kina sasa tutaidia hapa tu, lambu tatu wakuja na mbwa.
When the search team announced yesterday that they had positive IDs of those persons who had been reported missing and the bodies in the morgue, the villagers were dejected. Their suspicions have been confirmed true this morning when the body of a child was found 5 meters from where I'm standing. However, regional coordinator Mongo Chimwanga has defended the scaling down of the search and rescue mission, adding that residents should help by reporting all persons who are still missing to this point.
So we've asked for the affected families to ask one another if there's anybody who has not registered any missing person. They do come to the tracing desk so that we register. Because like this body that was recovered, it has not been registered in the missing persons list.
The security committee in the Senate, led by Yusuf Haji and flanked by Nakuru Senator Susan Kihika, visited Solai this morning to condole with the families who lost their loved ones in the tragedy. Meanwhile, plans are currently underway for an interdenominational prayer that will take place on Wednesday. Elphas Lagat, KTN News.